Hi, I am Clay Michel. Let's talk about baseball. Let's play ball.
Here are the worst contracts in Major League Baseball history. Kei Igawad, 5-year, $20 million with the New York Yankees. Kei Igawad is the most expensive minor league player of the franchise history. Bobby Bonilla, 25-year, $29.8 million for his release by the New York Mets. Bobby Bonilla's second stint with the Mets was horrible. He only hit for 160, he often clashed with manager Bobby Valentine, and during the sixth game of the 1999 National League Championship Series, he sat in the clubhouse playing cards with teammate Ricky Henderson. The Atlanta Braves eliminated the Mets during that game. When came the time for the Mets to release him, Bonilla and his agent offered the Mets a deal. Bonilla would defer payment for a decade, and the Mets would pay him an annual paycheck of $1.19 million starting in 2011 and ending in 2035, adding up to a total payout of $29.8 million. Because team owner Fred Wilpon is stupid, he accepted the deal. Speaking of stupidity, Wilpon was heavily invested with Ponzi scheme operator Bernie Madoff, and the 10% returns he thought he was getting on his investments with Madoff outweighed the 8% interest the Mets would be paying on Bonilla's initial $5.9 million. As a result, the Madoff investment scandal nearly killed the Mets. So instead of a quick $5.9 million investment, the Mets gave $29.8 million to a past his prime and selfish player. Guess who have the last laugh? Milton Bradley. 3-year, $30 million with the Chicago Cubs. Milton Bradley, the player, not the board game manufacturer who created Battleship and Twister, was a notorious clubhouse cancer. At the end of the 2009 season, his first of his contract, Bradley was suspended of criticizing the team and saying, "You understand why they haven't won in 100 years here." The Cubs later traded him to the Seattle Mariners. For the remainder of his contract, he hit for 234 in 101 games. Russ Ortiz. 4-year, $33 million with the Arizona Diamondbacks. Russ Ortiz was a good pitcher with the San Francisco Giants and the Atlanta Braves. Suddenly in Arizona, he suffered from the Steve Blass disease. With an ERA of 7, Ortiz was so bad, the team released him at the middle of his second season of his contract. Oliver Perez. 3-year, $36 million with the New York Mets. A bad starting pitcher often in the disabled list, Oliver Perez was demoted to the bullpen. Despite both his poor play and repeated attempts by the Mets front office, he refused to go in the minor leagues to work on his pitching. He is slated to release before the last year of his contract. Carl Pavano. 4-year, $39.95 million with the New York Yankees. Carl Pavano spent more time in the disabled list than in the active roster. In fact, Pavano played less games with the Yankees than during his last season with the Florida Marlins. His injuries led the media to call him American Idol. Jason Schmidt. 3-year, $47 million with the Los Angeles Dodgers. Jason Schmidt ended his career the worst way possible. He was either horrible on the mound or injured. He missed the entire 2008 season, his second of his contract due to injury. B.J. Ryan. 5-year, $47 million with the Toronto Blue Jays. This was the largest contract for a reliever in Major League Baseball history, surpassing Mariano Rivera's 4-year, $40 million deal with the Yankees from 2001 to 2004. After a fantastic start in 2006, B.J. Ryan missed most of the 2007 season due to Tommy John surgery. Ryan's role in the bullpen was taken by Jeremy Accardo and Casey Jansen, with Accardo making the league minimum salary. Less than a year later, he made a successful comeback. In 2009, due to injury and ineffectiveness, Ryan lost his closer role and was later released. At the time, the Blue Jays were still responsible for the roughly $5 million remaining on his contract for the remainder of 2009, as well as the $10 million he was owed for 2010. This is how B.J. Ryan's career in the MLB ended. Jonathan Poppelman. 4-year, $50 million with the Philadelphia Phillies. Giving an absurd amount of money to a closing pitcher is dumb. The Blue Jays learned it the hard way. The Phillies are lucky that Jonathan Poppleman was effective. However, Poppleman was critical of the team. Once traded to the Washington Nationals, the pitcher became known for attacking Bryce Harper after the latter's at bat. Not the kind of player you want in the clubhouse.
I hope you enjoy this video. Please subscribe and feel free to comment. I'm sorry if my English is not good.